standing on the promises
of Christ my King.
Promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God.
Thou art worthy.
Worthy.
Oh, art
worthy. Worthy, O Lord.
Worthy, O Lord.
To
receive glory, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure thou art created. Thou art worthy, thou art worthy. Body, O Lord, holy, glory, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure thou art
created.
Alpha and Omega,
Omega,
they worship
and
you are Alpha and Omega, they worship you. Violations. We are going to take these prayer points. Okay, but first of all, I want to read something from the book of Jeremiah 23, verses 23 to 24. It says, I am only a God nearby, declares the Lord. I am not a God far away. Can anyone hide in secret places so that I cannot see him? Declares the Lord. Do not I fill earth and heaven, declares the Lord. What God is saying here is that God is everywhere. Okay? So that is what God is just trying to tell us from that scripture. God fills the heaven and the earth. There is no place where God is not. There is no place where things happen and God does not know about it. This is a very, very fantastic thing. And I also want so that your faith can come up. Okay? God is everywhere. If you look at Psalm 139, I read from verse 1, say, oh Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I arise. Can you imagine? You may be sitting there, God, We were rising up, God knows. You perceive my thoughts. Even what you are thinking, God perceives it. This is a very deep revelation from the Bible. Okay? From our father, he said, you discern my going in, out, and my lie down. You are familiar with all my ways. God knows all our ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you have known it completely. So everything I want to ask from God today, God has already known it. And he will answer in the mighty name of Jesus. It is
Amen.
A night of victory. It is a night for the conquerors. You shall be more than conquerors in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You shall be more than your conquerors in the mighty name of Jesus. When I say you,
Amen.
Your son, okay? You shall be more than conquerors in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, I read and say, oh Lord, listen, I like to say, oh Lord, you help me in behind and before. Can you imagine? H-E-M, that is in the international version. So God is helping you, okay, before and what? After, behind and before. So God is in front of you, it's also at your back. It shows the omnipresent power of God Almighty. He said, you have laid your hand upon me. Praise the name of the Lord. What beautiful language, what a wonderful unfolding of the greatness of God. God's presence permeates the entire universe. There is nowhere that you can go and God will not see and protect you. So I want to pray. I just want to, so that your faith can come up, can fire up very, very well. Okay? The Holy Spirit has been active in the universe from the creation up to this level. Praise the name of the Lord. So you are going to
Hallelujah.
Ancestral covenants.
Ancestral covenants.
Ancestral covenants. And my child. I break it right now. In the name of
Jesus. I break it right now in the name of Jesus.
Ancestral covenants
against me.
In the name of Jesus.
Break right now in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Break right now.
Power in the mighty name of Jesus. Every ancestral power against me, my son, my father, my God. Break
now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Inherited family covenants.
Inherited family covenant
that may affect me and my child in the future.
Oh, that may affect me and my
child in the future. And lose your hold.
Break and lose your hold. Ancestral covenants that may affect me
family covenant
and my child.
Ancestral
covenant.
In the name of Jesus. Inherited
covenant and my son. Every inherited covenant. Lose your hold in the name of
Jesus.
Lose your hold. Lose your hold. Every ancestral covenant, Jesus, Amen.
Any
Amen.
Evil covenant prospering in my family. Any evil covenant prospering.
Any evil covenant
anywhere.
Prospering in my family.
Break
right now in the name of Jesus. Every evil covenant prospering in my family. Break right now in the name of Jesus. Every evil covenant, I command you to break. Every evil covenant, break in the name of Jesus. Every covenant, break in the name of Jesus.
Say, every tie and covenant between me and ancestral spirit, we are break. And this right now, I'm also so. Even so, tight covenant
in the name of
and ancestral crown, break in the name of Jesus. Break right now. In the name of Jesus. Break right now.
Break right now.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say every so tight covenant with any dead relations, break in the name of Jesus.
Every soul covenant with any dead relations, break in the name of Jesus. Every soul covenant with any dead
relations, break in the name of Jesus.
Every
break. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Every soul covenant with family idols.
Every
soul covenant with family idols. Shrines and spirits. When you break, soul covenant with family idols. Shrines and spirits, I break right now. Open my bread right now. Every soul type of man, they do family idols. Shine and spirit, pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, every soul type covenant between you and your family and your parents and your grandparents. Your father and mother, we are breaking that.
Every single covenant between me and my grandparents.
Grandparents. Oh, yeah, that no source. Every soul type covenant. Oh, yeah, between me and
every soul type
relations. Break in the atmosphere.
Ministry against my son. I command you to break in the name of Jesus. Every evil priest, ministry against my son. Break in the name of Jesus. Every evil priest, ministry against me. In the name of Jesus. I command you to break in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are going to pray. Say, I withdraw my name. And the name of
I withdraw my name
from any
and the name of my son
in the open
from altar, altar.
We draw that
in the name of Jesus.
From
I withdraw my
name
from
every
altar. In the name of Jesus. Matilda, I withdraw your name from every evil altar. I withdraw his name, David, from every evil altar. In the name of Jesus.
From any altar, in Jesus' name we pray. Every stubborn altar, priest. Assigned against me and my child, there in that most of stubborn altar priest,
every altar priest against me and my child, I command to die the most. Every altar priest against me and my child, I command to die the most.
Before we go to the message,
every altar priest, I command to die the most.
Every future battle.
Every future battle
awaiting me and my child, scatter all over the place. Every future battle. Command it to scatter
right now. Me and my son. I command you to scatter the name of Jesus.
Command it to scatter right now. In that most of store, scatter right now. Command it to scatter right now. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
I've just shown us that God is everywhere. And this is an important message because the word of God, we cannot brush it about his spiritual warfare. The word and the spirit, they work together. Once you have a teaching, through that teaching, you understand what you are doing. As you are listening to that teaching, you begin to know how the path of darkness can be disarmed. Okay? The Bible says, we are not fighting what against flesh and blood, but what against principalities and
powers. Principalities and powers.
Power that is greater than the power of God. There is no power that is greater than the power of the Almighty God. God is omnipotent. And that omnipotent God will deliver you completely in the name of Jesus. I am talking about what I call
Amen.
Deliverance from the ministry of covenant violations. Deliverance from the ministry of covenant violations. Listen to the message very well because this is what the Holy Spirit asked me to do. You see, number one, covenant is one of the stronger powers or forces that can bind two or more people together in the spiritual realm. Very, very powerful. Number two, God who operates with covenant. Many creatures of God operate through covenants. Abraham's blessings was based on covenants between man and God. Then, blessed is the man or woman who makes covenant with God and keep them. The Bible says, have respect unto the covenant because the dark places are full of the habitation of cruelty. That is Psalm 74, verse number 20. If you look at the book of Genesis chapter 17, verses 10 to 13, Genesis chapter 17, verse 10 to 13, say, this is my covenant which you shall keep between me and you, and your descendants after you. Every male shed among you shall be circumcised, and you shall be circumcised in the flesh of your first kings. And it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and you. He who is 80 days old among you shall be circumcised. Every male child in your generations, he who is born in your house or born in money, any foreigner who is not your descendant, he who is born in your house and he who is bought with your money, must be circumcised, and my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting covenant. Say, my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting covenant. I want to explain that page. That was God that is making a covenant with Abraham. I want to pay attention to verse 30. Say, and my covenant shall be in your flesh for the everlasting covenant. If the covenant made between God and Abraham will remain in the flesh, the flesh there stands for blood and water of that person. The flesh there stands for what? The water and the blood of that person. That's why people, they say, they pray, nothing happens. If you don't go deep, nothing will happen. The flesh there stands for what? The what? Flesh.
Blood and water.
The blood flesh. And the water, God bless you. That is why the covenant made by our forefather, their sin was how to break it. If people will understand this, spiritual warfare will be very, very easy for them. This is the ABC of spiritual warfare. Anybody that understands what I'm saying, he can easily gain victory. Ship victory over the adversaries. I remember we did some similar program for a family last week. The person dreamt and saw all kinds of hampers. It was fantastic things. We are not doing this, we don't put people on fast and we are eating. No, it's not possible that way. Because you can see God made covenant with Abraham. Say, my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting. For an everlasting. And you know what everlasting is? Forever and ever. Praise the name of the Lord. The flesh stands for water and blood. It remains an everlasting covenant. Woe unto the man or woman that enter into a covenant with the devil. The devil is a master of counterfeit. He lost people into all kinds of evil covenants, binding them to himself by force. So many people, they enter covenant through dreams. Some people, our forefathers, they enter covenant. All human races were in a sort of one covenant or another with the devil until Jesus came to deliver us. If not, the covenant will continue speaking. You are going to close and say, any evil covenant made by anybody to be speaking against me and my child, I break it tonight. In the name of Jesus.
Every evil covenant.
Any covenant made that is speaking in the future.
That is
speaking. Will be broken. Be broken.
In the future, be broken in the name of Jesus.
In
every
Jesus
evil covenant.
Mighty name we pray.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Thing I want you to notice this. Most of our cultural heritages and festivals, they have links with satanic covenants. This is why quite a lot of people suffer. I know in my village they carry masquerades. In my village they have all kinds of festivals that people do. They are linked to satanic covenants. This is where a whole people from a particular family, a whole people from a particular village, they can be sovereign. I am talking about the mystery of covenant violations. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Majority of our monuments, they are symbols of evil covenants. If you go to Marina Nalu, which is Shango, are the symbol of Nepa there in those days. Praise the name of the Lord. Satan has unforgiving character, a merciless and cruel agent. A covenant is an everlasting agreement unless it is broken. That is why breaking covenant sometimes it requires fasting. It's not something somebody got. It has been there for years. That is why an unborn child is bound by the consequences of broken covenant by their parents. I say that again. Unborn child is by what? By the consequences of broken covenant. We have read that place. Covenants can be in form of a vow. It can be in form of a promise. It can be in form of an agreement. Covenants can be seen by different kinds of things. The things that are used to seal covenants is called tokens in Bible times. T-O-K-E-N-S. They can be in form of a gift. They can be in form of a sacrifice. Okay, go to the road junction and sacrifice this. Or bring money and so on. We call them tokens of covenants. Or bring so. These are tokens. Every token of any covenant.
Every token of any covenant against me and my child, be broken in the name of Jesus.
Can be in form of food. They can say, go and cook food and give to the needy. These tokens, they give support to the covenant. They stand as witness to the covenant. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Violation of covenant is punishable offense. It does not matter who broke the covenant.
As long as you are bound to the covenant, either by blood or by nativity. When I say nativity, where you came from, you will see. I'm going to look at the Bible. So that is why you are bound to the covenant by blood and by what? By nativity. That is why you see people from a particular place, they are not doing well. They are bound to the covenant by what? By nativity. This is a kind of message that people need that will set them free. This is a kind of message that people need individually, but ironically, only very people will accept it. Covenants, you are bound to live by blood or nativity. The mere fact that my grandfather now was an idol worshiper. The covenants he made with all the family idols, I am bound to it. Thank God we broke it. Where I came from, my place of nativity, the same thing. Either knowing or knowing, you are bound to those covenants. That person will be punished for violating the covenants. God told Abraham in verse 14 of where we just says, he said, and the uncircumcised male child who is not, circumcised in the flesh of his foreskin, that person shall be cut off from his people. He has broken my covenant. That is where we are just read it now. If you look at that word, in Genesis chapter 17, verse 14, let me bring this so that my sister can see it. Okay? He said, and the uncircumcised male child who is not circumcised in the flesh of his foreskin, that person shall be cut off from his people. He had broken my covenant. You can see it. Now, such persons shall be cut off from the congregation of God's people. When one is cut off from the congregation of God, he or she is either directly or indirectly cut off from God. And where will such a person be? Praise the name of the Lord.
Now, hallelujah.
Our parents, many of our village leaders, some of our head of state, they enter into evil covenants with the devil for protection, for money and wealth, for power and fame. Many of us, we grew under the protection of evil covenants made with God. In fact, our parents sponsor us to school with those money. They sponsor us with the money. Okay? A lot of us, we grew under the protection of the covenants made by deities. They will say, Ogun, protect every member of these people. That's what they are worshiping. Or the waters will protect them. This is a problem of the black race. I was reading some of the article people are talking about the black in America, the blacks in South America, in Guyana, in Brazil, and so on and so forth. It's all over. This is a problem of the black race. We grew under the protection of the covenant with deities. Some, they grew under the protection of the covenant with the water spirits. Some, they grew under the protection of the covenants with mammon spirit. The devil never forgets covenants. He will involve such covenants with the present and yet unborn generations. That is why as Christians, we need to pray for our children. Some of the things happening there, they are not ordinary. This is the danger of covenant violation. Satan will make life miserable for anyone that violates any of his covenant with him, as well as the descendants of that person, who made it difficult. Will you close and say, hidden covenants.
Hidden covenants.
I break you now. In the name of
Jesus. I break you now.
Oh, in the name of Jesus. Break right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and say, break it.
Hidden covenants. Hidden covenants. Break in the name of Jesus.
Hidden covenants. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
In God for that just person. In the name of Jesus, all the hidden covenant, I break it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As I hear this message, the angels are walking on your behalf. In Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, God.
Angels are surrounding you. I can see them. You may not see them. Yes, that is
Amen.
It. That is it. Pia Kapuri Basaka Paraba. This Kapuri Basinta Kariba. Rose Kapuri Baba. Yes. Yes. Look at it. Let's get post-lover. In Jesus.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
When a covenant is violated, it can bring terrible diseases. It can bring untimely death. It can bring abject poverty. It can bring madness. Somebody called me today, said, Pastor, somebody said he's going to get mad. I said, okay, don't worry. Okay? I told the person to start fasting tomorrow. When people volunteer covenant, it can place embargo on the entire family involved. Say, covenant embargo on my family.
covenant embargo on my family.
I break it today. In the name
of Jesus. Covenant embargo on my
family.